pages, you don't require really any IDE. But if you have some IDE, that's better. Something like Eclipse, if you have, then comfortably you can do it. Either Eclipse or VisualStudio.net, using them, you can do it. Okay, but even using simple Notepad also, you develop HTML pages. Are you well versed with HTML, like HTML 4.0 or HTML 5.0? See, in the case of Salesforce, ready-made templates are available, automatically they generate the required code. But behind it is definitely the HTML. Okay, so in the case of HTML, we have two different sections. One is head section, other one is body section. Like this you have. Now this is the turn of body. In the body, whatever you would like to show, you are going to show here. Okay, so this is going to be normally. Are you seeing my screen, Srinivas?
Yes, I am sure.
Okay, so this is what exactly simple HTML page I created. Whatever you see in the web browser, it is purely HTML. Unless it is some video or audio, it is going to be purely HTML. But when you are seeing video, it may be SW file or it may be some Silverlight based file. Otherwise, it's going to be pure HTML because browsers can understand only HTML. Browsers understand three different things. One is HTML, second thing is CSS, other one is JavaScript. HTML basically renders content on the screen. It's going to show content on the screen. Okay, CSS role is to style the content. Sometimes you want to show in red color, sometimes you want to show in bigger color, sometimes you want to show with bold, sometimes italicized you want to show. So for that, you require some styling features. So using styles, you can render like that. It's called a styling. So on the screen, you want to lay out elements. Something should come in the left side, something should come in the right side, something should be coming at the bottom, something should come in the completely top. So like that, you need to go for a layout. In laying out things, actually, CSS helps you. Cascading style sheets, we say it. Then after that, provide dynamism to the web pages, JavaScript actually helps you. See, there are two types of websites, web applications we have, 1.0 based and 2.0 based. When we talk about 1.0, it was information centric. That was the web 1.0 generation. So it was only information centric. Whatever information you have, you can just put in a page and page renders in the browser. That was with the web 1.0. But these days we are using web 2.0. So web 2.0 is going to be dynamic and user centric. In whatever way the user wants to see page, user wants to configure the page, the user can configure, user can see, that is web 2.0. It's based on the web 2.0. So these days everywhere you have web 2.0. And because of this web, what is happening? We are developing applications, everything is cloud-based and web-based. Mostly here we use the HTML. When we use HTML, normally you can create static pages. But dynamically, user should be selecting required thing. Content, from time to time, user would like to change. And many such operations user wants to do. So in such cases, JavaScript is going to be helping. JavaScript is a scripting language, it's nothing but interpreter, which is part of the browser. It's not any separate software. Okay, so it is part of the browser. Your browser must be enabled to run the JavaScript. Otherwise, JavaScript cannot be running. And whatever code you write, you are going to write code and you are going to keep in your web pages. Either you go with inline JavaScript or you may be doing with internal internal JavaScript or it may be external JavaScript files you are going to refer in your application. So all these AngularJS, jQuery, let's say you have many other tools like KnockoutJS, Backbone, Ember, all these are nothing but different JavaScript frameworks. On top of existing JavaScript, they have been developed. Okay, on top of existing JavaScript, they have been developed. AngularJS is useful in the case of single page applications. But to understand AngularJS, you have to understand HTML as well as JavaScript. Even CSS you need to understand. then how to use effectively JavaScript and AngularJS, you understand. AngularJS is nothing but it is actually a flavor of JavaScript. It's one of the APIs. API is nothing but application programming interface. Instead of we develop everything from scratch, whatever AngularJS can do, we can do with normal JavaScript. But doing with that is going to be time consuming process. So instead of that, we use already developed AngularJS framework. With that very quickly, we develop actually the single page applications. Okay, to develop single page applications, we use actually here AngularJS. Okay, AngularJS library you can download from the Google website. It's called a CDN, Content Delivery Network, or it can be from the Content Delivery Network. From there you can download, or you can be referring every time your page downloads. So it is advisable to download from it's advisable to refer in the CDN. CDN is Content Delivery Network. From there always the page has to be downloading it. So whenever a page is getting rendered in the browser, three things happen. Whatever resources are available, they are downloaded, like images, links, all this will be downloaded into browser and then it shows in the web page. Second thing, whatever CSS files are available, they also get downloaded. And one more thing, JavaScript files. Whatever JavaScript files are there, they also get downloaded and they get their render in your and in browser. So three things happen. HTML content is downloaded. Similarly, the CSS is downloaded. One more thing is JavaScript also downloaded. AngularJS is nothing but one such library. It's nothing but JavaScript library. So once AngularJS is downloaded, whatever you would like to do with AngularJS, you can do it. For downloading it, either you can refer it from the CDN or you can download and you can put in your local server. Local server in the sense wherever you host your application, wherever you host your website, there you can actually download and keep. So that way normally JavaScript works. But before proceeding with AngularJS, as I told you, you should know what is JavaScript and how to write JavaScript code. That's going to be important. Now here I show you the script followed by type equal to here text oblique JavaScript. Like this we should write. Text oblique JavaScript. Then here inside this we should write the JavaScript. And it has here a starting tag and a closing tag. HTML is based on the tags. We have a starting tag, we have a closing tag. In between this we should write the required code. Now here come to the body. So within the body I try to define some button. I'm going to define a button here. It's called as input. The type is called as here attribute. What type of input this is. Type equal to button I put here. Then I can attach here some JavaScript code. On click I write here. On click equal to here you should write the required JavaScript code. Alert. Welcome to JavaScript. So welcome to JavaScript. Like this I can go with the inline JavaScript code. Alert is a dialog box. If you work with Windows, probably you know about different types of dialog boxes. Few dialog boxes just they show message. Other dialog box they give you an option to select either yes or no. So one is called a simple alert, other one is called as a confirm. Confirmation, that is. Whether you are proceeding or whether you are cancelling, you can do with yes or no. So same thing happens here also. Using alert, I can display some message. Okay, so this is what exactly, this is a button I am creating on the screen. Then I try to put like this. Click me is the message I want to put on the screen. I created a button. This I can render somewhere on the somewhere in the browser I can render it. Okay, so just go to D drive. In the D drive, I make here new folder HTML pages. And in these HTML pages, I'm going to save it. This file is going to be select here HTML pages. This is going to be a HTML page. first.html. I just make a file like this here. Now if I come to the redirect, here in the HTML pages, I can find. This is what exactly first.html page is created. I can open using Google Chrome here, this one. You can see a button. When you click on the button, it says, welcome to JavaScript. It says here, welcome to JavaScript. How this is firing? This I am making to, happen with the help of the JavaScript. I have written JavaScript code, with that it is working that way. You can see here, when you look at code, here I have written input type equal to button, on click equal to alert, welcome to JavaScript, value equal to click me. Like this, I have written some code. When I click on that, it is showing the message, welcome to JavaScript. This is called as here, giving alert message. Now similarly, what I do, I input two numbers, I add them and I put into some another text box. I can use like this. Here input type equal to, it is text. Similarly, ID is num1, put like this. ID is num1. Then similarly, here I use a plus symbol, then I do with the input type equal to here, again text. I should specify, these are called as attributes. So type is nothing but attribute. Input is nothing but element, HTML element. When you put type equal to text, it becomes actually a text box. Then ID is here num2. We put like num2 here. Okay, this is going to be num2. Then followed by here, I write equal. Then here I use another element called as span. ID, this is called an inline element. ID is result. ID is going to be here result. I create a span in this manner, slash followed by span. Then here in the bottom, I create one more button. So using that button, I want to calculate here input type equal to button here, this one. Next write ID equal to this btn result. This should be calculating some result. Then on click equal to here, we write on click equal to calculate. I should write a function in JavaScript that I should be calling here. Value equal to, I write the value which appears on the bottom. Value is calculate. Okay, so like this, I want to go with input elements. I have a button, then I have two text boxes. Result I want to store somewhere in the span. Span is called as actually inline. It's inline. Otherwise, div or body is going to be block kind of things. This is inline here. When I click on the button here, it should be calculating result and should put in the, say, the span. In the span, it should be coming. Further, I write now a function. Function name must be here, calculate. Function name is going to be here, calculate. Here write function, then followed by calculate. Then inside this, we should write the required code. The code here is, first of all, I should be retrieving values from the num1 and num2. Okay, how to retrieve using ID, I can do it. Here I can write document dot var num1. Var is the keyword, with the help of that you can declare a variable. You cannot have any data type prior to the variable name. In Java we use some variable name like int a, int b, like that we use. But here we cannot use anything like that. Var num1 we declare like this a variable. So once we declare variable, you can assign a value. When you assign value, at that time the type will be inferred. JavaScript supports actually, numbers. It supports characters. It supports actually undefined. It supports undefined. Okay. Similarly, it supports null. And also it supports date object. as well as string object. It has string object, and data types like numeric. In the numeric, again, it's going to be, say, approximate values and fixed values. In the case of integers, it's going to be fixed values, but when you work with approximate, in such cases, it's going to be float or double, that kind of data. So, by default, it's going to be supporting always numeric value, it is double. Up to 18 bits, 18 digits, it's going to support in the number. Very big actually, the number in the JavaScript is. So here, when I put var num1 equal to, what happens exactly? It is declaring a variable, but no type of data is associated. So here I write parse int. I am going to convert into integer. I mean, whatever data I have in the text box, it is in the form of text. I need to convert into number. So therefore I write parse int. Here then document dot, this is called as DOM. DOM stands for document object model. Document dot get element by ID. Okay, then here I should use the ID is num1. Num1 value I can take, then I can assign here value. So this way I have written. In the same manner, I can use another variable. I can be using here one more variable called as num2. Second number also I can be picking here with this. This is num2, I get a value here. Then followed by here, I need to get the result. Result is going to be addition because I have used the plus. Therefore, it should be addition. Where num3 is num1 plus num2. We use like this. Now the result, whatever I get, I should assign to span here. It should be going into span. Therefore, write document dot get element by ID. Again, get element by ID. Here we use the span is called result. Then here dot inner text. So inner text, this time I should be converting num3 into string dot toString. Into string I convert and I assign here. Like this, I can make this happening. This is a JavaScript code I have written. The function is what here? Calculate. I am going to call this calculate function when I click on the button. So let me render this in the browser. First, here this is. You can see we have a click, click me. When you click on that, it's going to show welcome to JavaScript. Here you can enter numbers. I enter 20. Then followed by I enter 30, when I click on calculate, it should give 50. It's showing you here 50, you can see. 20 plus 30 is 50, like this you can do. So without refreshing page, you do in the client side, this you can do with the help of JavaScript. Using JavaScript, you can do this. So without having idea with JavaScript, learning AngularJS is really, it's not possible. You need to be knowing first of all JavaScript thoroughly. Then if you do with AngularJS, that's going to be really fine. Because AngularJS is going to be using arrays as well as objects. Okay, we have array concept, then similarly objects concept, and we have JSON also. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. So using JSON, it works a lot. AngularJS is going to be working with that particular concept. And apart from that, you have a routing concept in that. You have a routing concept. So routing engine, we have the help of the routing engine using a URL without specified page name, we can be seeing different views. Routing is also going to be very, very important with the AngularJS. So before you proceed with AngularJS, you have to know definitely about JavaScript and you have to know about HTML. So if you know about those, then you can comfortably learn AngularJS. AngularJS is, as I told, it is the MVC framework, model view controller. Little bit idea on MVC also required. If you have worked with Java, with enterprise applications, or if you have worked with .NET, in such cases, you know what is MVC. You have a model, you have a view, you have a controller. Model is nothing but it is business logic as well as data, which you normally get from database or from the views. Controller is going to be a coordinator between the model and view. View is nothing but HTML, whatever you see. Okay, so this way it is going to be MVC framework, model, view, controller framework. With the help of that, what exactly you do, you are going to be retrieving data from server side. But when you want to retrieve data from server side, you may be using some web services or you may be using web API. Web API stands for Web Application Programming Interface, using which we can be getting data. But whenever you use AngularJS, data is going to be in the form of JSON, JavaScript Object Notation. With the help of that, you are going to retrieve data. JavaScript object is nothing but it is an object using JavaScript to create. So here everything is going to be in the, in the form of properties and methods. You have methods as well as properties. You can create a class, using that class you can create an object. When you create an object, the object can contain the properties as well as methods. So methods can be working on the data. Properties are nothing but data. Properties only give state for the given object. Okay. So to proceed with AngularJS, you need to know about the JavaScript, HTML, and little bit CSS also. This is needed, Srinivas. Srinivas, are you following me?
Hello.
Hello, Srinivas, are you following me?
Yeah, but I didn't that much knowledge on HTML and JavaScript.
Because to manipulate HTML elements only use AngularJS.
But
okay,
I didn't
attach code to the HTML elements only. You are going to further make powerful HTML elements with the help of AngularJS.
Okay. But I want to learn. But I want to learn first this JavaScript, I think.
Yes, you need to know. But where do you apply JavaScript? You are learning JavaScript, but where do you use JavaScript? Getting my point, you need to use with HTML elements only, correct?
Okay. Yes, yes.
So without knowing that where you apply, whatever you know, it should be from HTML element.
Yes.
So JavaScript works in the browser only, that to AngularJS. Suppose if it's node-based, it's Node.js. In the case of Node.js, server-side code you can do, server-side coding you can do. But as far as AngularJS is concerned, it's for presentation layer only. It's for actually presentation layer, it's going to be for view only. So therefore, you have to know about these. So initially you have to start with HTML, then I need to tell about one day for HTML, one day for CSS, one day for giving introduction to JavaScript, then after that we can start AngularJS.
Okay.
And I can give you few links by going through the links. Ready-made video tutorials are available. You can go through them and you can understand all these.
Okay, sure.
Will you have time for that? Because each and every video it lasts about 1 hour, something like that. Okay, so there are about 16 to 17 videos in recent times I made. That means it's going to be about 16 hours.
Okay. Oh, I have time.
It's totally about, yeah, it is totally about HTML.
Okay.
HTML, CSS and JavaScript on that. You can understand basics of those. Understood, Srinivas?
Yes, I got it.
Okay. So without that, definitely you cannot do much. I mean, you have to know about all these things. Then you can comfortably work with the AngularJS.
Sure.
Okay. So you require some ID probably Eclipse, or it can be say some other ID, whatever you feel comfortable that you can use.
Well, you
so here without using any ID I made this. Without using any ID I have done it.
Oh, yes.
I have used just Notepad. Using Notepad only I could make it. So but if you have some ID, that helps you very much.
Okay. I want to install Eclipse.
You need to install Eclipse. J2EE version, Enterprise Edition Eclipse you need to download. Latest version something like Lunar you have.
Yes. Already I have Eclipse, I use it in the Salesforce. Can you?
Okay. Fine, then that is enough. I mean Eclipse, which version that is? Is it Kepler or what version that is?
This is Mars, same you use it.
Okay, Mars. Fine. You can use Mars. In recent times, in 2015, it got released actually. You can use Mars. Okay. You have installed Java in your system?
No, I don't think so.
Okay. No, without that also you can do with JavaScript, but ultimately how do you get connected to server, that is going to be important.
Okay.
Because you may create something in the client side, but you need to fetch data from server from time to time, correct?
Yes.
So how do you fetch data? How do you render the data here? Some kind of source is required in the background. So then only you can fetch data and you can render in the HTML page.
Okay.
Salesforce, anything like, do you have offline, that means without getting connected to server, Salesforce application, anything, do you have like that, which you can install in your computer and do some applications, develop some applications?
No, without without online, we don't do any single thing in Salesforce.
Yes, because that's cloud-based.
Yeah, you should have connection.
And it's using, I mean, a language called as Apex, I think.
Yeah, Apex course.
So Apex is similar to JavaScript. Apex is similar to Java.
A little bit like.
Yes. Same concept, Oops concept you have even in that.
Yeah, same. They have in constructors, functions. Yes. Sometimes they mostly use some functions.
Yes.
And afterwards they use triggers. That is enough for the
triggers to fire automatically. In databases, how you use? You have database knowledge. Anything like SQL Server, Oracle?
Yeah, I have knowledge in SQL.
Because there also use triggers.
Yeah, yes.
DML triggers you have, or DDL triggers, or LAMA triggers you use in the DML. Again, you have after insert or after update, after delete, or instruct triggers also you have, I think.
Yeah. In Salesforce, you have all before trigger, after trigger. I mean, before action, after action.
Yes.
Before insert, after insert, same. These are all the same. You know, Salesforce also you have.
In the SQL Server, you have after and instead of. Instead of is going to be before.
Okay.
Before trigger. See, why they don't give they don't give access to other types of triggers, logon triggers. You are not an administrator. Okay, only administrators, Salesforce administrators, probably they have access to such things. And I think default internally they are using those triggers. So whenever logon trigger means who logged in, similarly you have actually DDL, data definition language triggers. Suppose you create a table, you create a procedure, you write some piece of code, you modify existing code. Even in such cases, it may be firing. The triggers may be firing, but we are not aware of those things because you are an end user, you are not an administrator, you are a normal programmer, so you don't require any features of those. But if you are a Salesforce administrator, definitely you need to know about those.
Say that.
Yes, so that is Trainng. What are your compatible timings, Trainng? What is your time zone?
Yeah, Central, CST.
CST time. This time, will it be okay for you every day?
Yeah, I will be okay for every time.
Okay. So, I mean, first 3 days we are going to work with HTML, CSS, JavaScript. I give you a little introduction on that. Further, you need to focus on those things. I can send you links from time to time. You need to go through the links and I give you examples also in those links. You need to go through that.
Okay.
Then after that, we start with the AngularJS.
Sure.
I have shared syllabus also with you, I think.
Okay.
But how you apply with Salesforce, I don't know really because I did not work much with Salesforce.
Yeah.
It depends on you how to integrate AngularJS with Salesforce.
Also, by styling the pages.
Okay, you use that. But see, in that, how many views normally you have? View is nothing but normal HTML pages. Normally, what we do, we navigate from one page to another page. Fine. So, similarly, how you do that? How normally, in a particular page, how many views you have?
I mean, you see multiple views. I mean, Oh, sorry, one single view, you just save the record. You can build a page like different fields and just you can save the records.
Yes, see, views are, for example, you take a Salesforce page. In the same page, you can add a new record, you can edit existing record. If you want to see the existing all records, whatever are there, you can see there. Similarly, if you want to delete record, you can do. You can perform all CRUD operations in single page.
Yes, in single
page. So, there you can be using actually the views concept.
Okay.
Single page only one page you take. You may be having some order object, sales order object you have.
Yes, we could only one page, that's it. Functions you do only a single page only.
That's what. So, they use actually single page application. But see, always you don't require all those features. Suppose you want to add a new sales order, for example, take. Related to that only it should appear on the screen, correct?
Yes.
Similarly, you are viewing existing records, only those records should be coming on the screen. Suppose you want to edit particular record, when you select a record, the editing part should appear on the screen, rest of the things have to be, should not be shown there. Similarly, you want to delete, when you click on delete, it shows the particulars of record, then when you try to click on delete, it should be giving you confirmation message. Really want to delete, really are you interested to delete that record, that message you get. So such things you need to incorporate in the page. Okay?
Okay.
That's what's in us. In 20 to 25 days, we can finish it.
Okay, sure. For this basic three classes, can you give some time, like what, one, two days more, I can learn quickly for.
So before that, I give you some links. You need to go through the links.
Yeah.
Okay. And just now I share the links with you. So those links you can take, and with that links you can do it.
Okay.
Because your time will not be wasted in spaces. Those links.